Cheers and greetings. Today I want to talk to you a little bit about baseball. Although I'm not sure this is really a baseball story, and if there's a moral to this story, I don't know what it is, but let me tell you the story. In the late 50s, like every young man of my age in a small town, we played Little League Baseball every summer. It was just a rite of passage. You had to play, I guess. I mean, all of your friends played. And you would go down to the local park, and there would be some sort of a tryout period, and the coaches or a coach would put you into teams, I assume based on some kind of a skill set, divide you up into teams, and then a local business would buy uniforms. You could be on the Bank of Kennett or the Cotton Exchange Bank or Carnet Appliance or whatever. You'd have these cool uniforms, and everybody turned out and you played Little League. This was before T-ball or any of these other things. This was Little League Baseball, and it, you know, was taken very seriously. I will tell you that I was shitty at Little League Baseball, at organized baseball. I was shitty at baseball, but I love baseball. I love going out and playing in the sand lot. We would play games like Indian ball, where you could play with as few as four people, or we'd play three flies and you're out, I think was, I mean, just, you'd hit, you know what it is. Girls, maybe you don't know, but the guys know what it is. And I loved that, and we would play that in the evening, and it was great. But you had to play Little League. And I was just terrible at it. The only time I ever got on base was when I would crowd the plate and get hit. And they had these little cardboard, you know, head protective gear that, anyway. But the story I want to tell you, or the diet I want to tell you about, was a beautiful summer evening. And, well, let me back up a second. You need to understand that in the late 50s, I'm not sure exactly where Willie Mays was in his career. And if you've never heard of Willie Mays, he was a very famous baseball player in the 50s, and I'm not sure exactly when he played. But he was big. And while Willie could not have played at our private country club in Kennett or gone to our local municipal swimming pool because both were segregated, he would have been a big deal in town. Willie Mays was just a big deal all over the country. So when a coach, a Little League coach, looks down at his roster and he sees that he's got somebody named Mays, he logically would put them in center field, assuming that he had to play them at all. So I spent a lot of time in center field, which was fine for me because I was less likely to get hit in the face with a bouncing ground ball. It was nice. It was quiet out there. Now, where we played ball at Jones Memorial Park in Kennett, Missouri, not too far, 40 or 50 yards behind deep center field, was a road, a street, and there was a little ice cream place. Now, this was before things like Dairy Queen and whatever. So this was just a little no-name ice cream thing. And they would play music in these little speakers outside the place for the kids that would come down to the park and then get pop and ice cream and stuff. And they were playing some kind of music that night. And as I often was when playing the outfield, I was sort of distracted. I was, you know, nothing ever happened. I was just waiting for the three outs so I'd go back in, waiting for the game to be over so I could go home and do something else. And I think I might have even been looking back over my shoulder, or might have even turned around, looking back at the little ice cream place, when I heard a roar from the crowd in the bleachers. And there was a good turnout, all the parents and everything. So I spun back around, I look in to see what's going on, and everybody, every face is turned looking right at me. And it quickly dawned on me, since I saw nothing rolling toward me on the ground, that somebody had hit a fly ball to center field, my area. So like one of these World War II air traffic, or not air traffic, what do they call them? Air spotters, the guys that would monitor the coastlines looking for Japanese fighters and bombers. So I'm scanning the skies, the perfect blue summer sky, evening sky, looking. And then I see it, I mean, I see this white speck and it's coming right toward me. I'm not gonna have to move a step, but I have to catch it. And if I miss this coming right to me, it'll be even more humiliating. But like, you know, a snake and a mongoose, I'm just sort of frozen watching this. and the ball falls out of the sky and hits me at full speed right in my bony little preteen chest. And it, you couldn't hear it back at the stands, but it makes a sort of boom. And because my hands were sort of down at my waist and my glove was down there, the ball just miraculously boom and bounces right into my glove. And I look down and I'm surprised. Well, what I'm telling you is my perspective, but what apparently they saw from the stands was a perfectly executed Willie Say Hey Mays basket catch. Now, a little history. As I recall, Willie Mays had this sort of signature catch. Instead of turning his glove up to catch a fly ball like this, or with two hands like this, he would just sort of hold his hands down at his waist, sort of cup his glove, and let the ball just fall into it. Boom. And as I recall, they called it a basket catch. So I had, to everybody's, as far as they could tell, I had executed this basket catch. So I'm trotting in and people are patting me on the back. And way to go, Say Hey, you know, way to go, Willie. And I never told anybody. The next day, of course, I had this massive contusion, this huge purplish eggplant bruise on my little chest where the ball had hit it. But, and as I think back on it now, I don't know if this was a great memory or an ironic memory or a pathetic memory, but that was the one thing I remember that passed for positive in my Little League experience. Now, what's the moral of this story? I don't know. But I'm inviting you to think about it. Don't be hasty. Think about it. Post it in the comments under this post. And let's see, lo these 40 or 50 years later, what wisdom you can share with me based on this story.